So now we'll discuss about the elasticity of demand. Actually, we will discuss about the measuring elasticity of demand in the case of a linear demand curve. So let us consider one demand curve. In horizontal axis we are measuring quantity, vertical axis we are measuring price. So AB is the demand curve and we want to measure the price elasticity of demand at point C. So at point C we find that price is OP0, quantity demanded is OQ0. So now we'll use the formula price elasticity of demand. So E equals to minus, we'll take a continuous form instead of a discrete form. So that's why we'll take minus dQ by dP into P by Q. Now, if this is a slope straight line, a continuous straight line, we can tell that its slope will be dQ by dP. Its slope will be given as dP by dQ because in vertical axis we are measuring price, horizontal axis we are measuring quantity. So dP by dQ can be written as anywhere we can draw a perpendicular. So perpendicular by base, this ratio will give us what is the what is the slope of the curve. The slope of the curve here is given as CQ0 by, so this is capital Q0, so this is CQ0 by Q0B. So here we are not going to consider about the direction, we will just consider the magnitude. This is already a downward sloping curve, so we need not give here minus. So now, what will be the dQ by dP? So dQ by dP will be nothing but inverse of, so dQ by dP, we want to measure dQ by dP, this is nothing but the inverse of Q0B by, Q0B by CQ0, this is capital. So here, what you see, that this is a rectangle, so opposite sides must be equal. So we can write that dQ by dP equals to Q0B by OP0. Now we have got the value of dQ by dP, now we have to multiply it with the price by quantity, ratio of price by quantity P by Q. So here price elasticity of demand will be given as Q0B by OP0 multiplied by OP0 by OQ0. So OP0, OP0 will be dismissed. So we will be get Q0B by OQ0. So this is the price elasticity of demand. Now, just we want to explain it more, that is, let us consider these two triangles AP0C and CQ0P. So first, if we consider these two angles, those are right angles. Number two, next. The P0C and OB are parallel lines and this straight line divides the two, intersects the two. So that's why these two angles, what we call the correspondence angles, these two are same. And for the same logic, these two angles are same. So we can say these two right angles are same. Next angle C, B, Q0 equals to angle A, C, P0. These two are same because these two are the corresponding angles and these two angles are also the corresponding angles. So these two triangles are, we can write the triangle A, P0, C and triangle C, Q0, B. These two are similar triangles. So now if we compare between two similar triangles, we have to remember the property that the ratio of respective two sides will be equal for these two triangles. So we can write here that the triangle, the ratio of base and perpendicular will be same for both triangles. So we can write that P0C divided by AC equals to Q0B divided by BC. So this is a rectangle. So OQ0, P0C can be replaced by OQ0 because opposite sides of the rectangle are always equal. So we write here OQ0 by AC equals to Q0B by BC. So finally, we can write that Q0B by OQ0 equals to BC divided by AC. So that means at this point C, the price elasticity of demand is the ratio of the lower segment and the upper segment. So from here we can conclude that at any point on the linear demand curve, at any point on the linear demand curve, the price elasticity of demand will be the ratio of lower segment divided by upper segment. So in this logic, at this midpoint, price elasticity of demand should be equal to 1. At any point below midpoint, the lower segment is greater than, less than upper segment. So price elasticity of demand is less than 1. At this point, what we see, that lower segment is 0. So price elasticity of demand is 0. Any point above the midpoint, here price elasticity of demand will be greater than 1 because lower segment is greater than the upper segment. And in this point E equals to 0. So from here we can come to the conclusion that if we consider a linear demand curve, the price elasticity of demand varies from 0 to infinity. At the bottom point it will be 0, at the midpoint it will be 1, below midpoint it will be less than 1, above midpoint it will be greater than 1, and at the top point it will be equals to infinite, because lower segment has its value, upper segment is 0. So price elasticity of demand varies from 0 to infinite along the same demand curve if we move from right to left. The next part is that, this is also a very crucial part, that is the relationship between price marginal revenue and the price elasticity of demand. So for this, first we need to learn, know what is total revenue. So total revenue is known as the multiplication of price into quantity. Price of the commodity multiplied by quantity sold. So marginal, what is marginal revenue? Marginal revenue means change in revenue for sale of one additional unit. So that means if we increase the revenue to sell by one unit, what will be impact on my revenue? So now how can I do it? We have to, that means for any marginal case, we have to differentiate it. So dr by dq. So it will be given as, if we differentiate in UV process, we'll get that P plus Q multiplied by dP by dQ. So this is the formula of marginal revenue. So now what we'll do? Just in left hand side, let it be as it is. P into 1 plus Q by P into dP by dQ. So now we'll make a manipulation of this part. So just remember, what is the formula of price elasticity of demand? E equals to minus dQ by dP into P by Q. So from here we can write that minus E equals to dQ by dP into P by Q, or if we take the inverse of it, so minus 1, or you can write that 1 divided by minus E equals to minus dP by dQ, dP by dQ into P by, it will be into Q by P. So from what we can do, 1 by minus E, we can replace this or manipulate this with the equation of 1 by minus E. So here if we write, we know minus multiplied by minus equals to plus. So we can write here dr by dq equals to minus of, P into 1 minus of 1 by minus dq by dp into p by q. So p into here 1 minus 1 divided by e. So this is the relationship between, so this is marginal revenue, this is the relationship between price, marginal revenue and price elasticity of demand. So from here we can say that if E equals to 1, that implies 1 by E equals to 1. So 1 minus 1 by E equals to 0. So marginal revenue equals to P into 0. So we can say here that if price elasticity of demand exactly equal to 1, the marginal revenue for the commodity, for the output, will be 0. Similarly, if we take E is greater than 1, what does that imply? 1 by E, that must be less than 1. And 1 minus 1 by E, that is greater than 1. So marginal revenue equals to P into 1 minus 1 by E. 1 minus 1 by E. So P cannot be negative, it is always positive. So P positive multiplied by positive will be positive. So marginal revenue is greater than positive. So if price elasticity of demand is greater than 1, what we can say? If output, our sale increases, our total revenue will increase. And third is the case of if E is less than 1. So that implies 1 by E, that is greater than 1. Or 1 minus 1 by E, that is less than 0. So what we can write here? That if P is positive, 1 minus 1 by negative, positive multiplied by something negative, so E, that implies marginal revenue will be negative. So what we can say, that if price elasticity of demand is less than 1, then If you increase the sale, your total revenue will fall. That's why marginal revenue will be negative. So marginal revenue is nothing but the ratio of change in total revenue, change in output. So marginal revenue 0 means there will be no change in total revenue. Marginal revenue greater than 1 means this is positive, both are positive. That means whenever the output increases, the revenue will rise. And marginal revenue negative means whenever the output increases, total revenue will fall. So this is how we can express the relationship between price, marginal revenue and price elasticity of demand.